Welcome to ClickMy project program. Let me discuss about the process prediction detection based on blob motion statistics. Initially, the videos are converted into frames. The frames are then pre-processed to remove the noises in them. The noises refers to the unwanted pixels in the frames. We use Gaussian filter to remove the noises in them. Then the background subtraction process is done. We can identify the blobs in the video using this process. Then the objects are identified by finding their centroid position, x and y coordinates of the blobs and their area, their height and width. Then the identified blobs were tracked by plotting a rectangular box around them based on the calculated values from the blobs. Now, the precious bits were wasted on a noisy video. Gaussian filter is applied to remove the noises from the frames. The Gaussian filter will smooth the video and make all the pixels in the images more clearer. In order to apply Gaussian filter, we use in filter function. Then in the background subtraction process is widely used approach for detecting moving objects in a video from static cameras. In this method, images foreground is extracted for further processing. This can be done in many ways. Here we are using frame differencing method in order to extract a foreground object. The difference between the image and the empty background image gives the foreground objects. The mean or median of the series of images removes the background. Every pixel intensity values in the video can be modeled using a Gaussian mixer model. Similarly, we can extract the backgrounds using different methods, but we are extracting using the frame differencing method. Then after that, the objects in the foreground objects were detected, and then they are labeled by measuring their centroid position, bounding box values, and then the x and y coordinates like that. So after labeled, the objects were labeled like that, a rectangle box were plotted around the detected objects by using the calculated values. Hence we are obtaining the moving pedestrians from the video. Thank you. Let me see the flow of the process pedestrian detection based on blob motion statistics. First, the input video is converted into frames. This is done by measuring the frame height and width and splitting the video based on the measured height and width. Then the input frames were pre-processed. Precious bits were wasted on a noisy video. The Gaussian filter is applied to remove the noises from the frames. This will smooth the video and make all the pixels in the image more clear. In order to apply Gaussian filter, we use in filter function. Then from the pre-processed frames, the backgrounds were eliminated. For this, we are using frame differencing background subtraction method. Here we are obtaining the foreground objects by subtracting the each frames from the empty background, so that we are getting the foreground objects. Then the extracted foreground objects were detected by only taking the white pixels, which is the result of the foreground objects. Then the objects are labeled by measuring their parameters. Here, the parameters refers to the back area, centroid position and bounding box of the obtained blobs. Then the based on the obtained objects labels, the objects were identified by plotting a rectangle box around the identified objects. This is done using the calculated area, bounding box and centroid positions of the blobs. Let me see the execution of the process pedestrian detection based on blob motion statistics. If you want to run the code, select the file main.m which is located in the source code folder. Right click it and select run file. You will get the user interface required to run the program. First, select the video which is present in the data. Now the video is loaded and it is converted into frames. The video is played in this location. Now the video is converted into frames. After converting into frames, pre-processing is applied. So the videos are pre-processed and saved in the folder pre-processed video. Then the background images subtracted. For background subtraction, we are using frame differencing method. So here the background from the images were subtracted so that we get extracted foreground object. Then we are extracting the bounding box over the extracted objects. Now we are plotting bounding boxes over the obtained objects so that we are tracking them. Thus we are identifying the walking pedestrians which is presented in the given video. Thank you.